championship against Braun Strowman and Kane in 6 weeks at the Royal Rumble event.
Well, I've never found it appropriate to bet against Brock Lesnar, but in this particular case, the odds certainly are stacked against our Universal Champion.
Did you see the Universal Champion, Brock Lesnar, a minute ago?
I absolutely did,
Brock. He's bad, man.
And here's a man as well, the King Slayer, who considers
somewhere else. How about that, huh?
Continuing to control Seth Rollins. Now the headlock as Joe has taken a seat at ringside to look on. And Corey, what do you make of this? Jason Jordan continuing to force his way into these situations.
I admire Jason Jordan's mindset. You want to shoot for the top of the mountain, and that's exactly what he's trying to do. We've seen Jordan hang and hold his own with Roman Reigns, with John Cena on multiple occasions. Jordan knows what he's capable of. He just wants to show the world.
Yeah, but at what point you're going to get bit by it? Look what happened last week. He cost Dean Ambrose a match against Samoa Joe. Ambrose was not happy about that. Now Rollins kicked right to the midsection of Jordan. Would love to make Jason pay as he sends him over the top rope right in front of Samoa Joe.
Big time here, son.
Rollins in control for the opportunity to meet Samoa Joe later tonight. This is here on Monday. Told us that the winner of this match will face Samoa Joe at some point in the future. Joe watching the match at ringside. And Jordan again sent over the top rope. It was supposed to be Joe versus Seth Rollins, but when Jason Jordan shoved Seth Rollins down, he said that Kurt Angle said it would be okay if we had a match tonight.
Oh, this was up to the mantra of Kurt Angle. Settle it in the ring.
And Seth Rollins caught by Jordan. Incredible power by Jordan.
He has a mean streak.
As is the man you were just looking at, Samoa Joe. But once again, watch Jordan. He's into the barricade.
See the barricade shift about 8 inches under the weight of both of these superstars. Totally changing the complexion of the match.
Jason Jordan tossing Rollins into the
hard move.
Cover. Hooks both legs this time and a kick out at two. Again, Jason Jordan continues to find himself in these situations. I think thanks in part to his father, the general manager, Kurt Angle.
One thing I can't say about Jordan tonight, he's changed his pace. He's slowing it down. I always tell young guys, that's the biggest thing. You got to know how to learn how to slow it down a little bit. And I think Jordan's got it.
And burying his shoulder into the spine of Rollins, whips him across the ring, and Seth again hits hard. Jordan working the back of Rollins. Moves him toward the center of the ring. Hooks a leg, kick out by Seth. Strategy, Corey, for Jason to work the back of Seth because Jason throws a lot of intense suplexes.
Definitely a solid game plan by Jordan to focus his attack on Rollins' lower back.
Yeah! Now Rollins driven again, spine first into the buckle. And Jason Jordan has taken control of this matchup as he again stares down at Samoa Joe, a man Jordan's wanted for the past couple of weeks after Joe insulted him here on Raw. Look at this. Again, the power of Jordan.
Jason just manhandled Rollins.
Well, Jordan's a big dude, Corey. He's a strong guy. He's got a tremendous amateur background. He's very quick. Former tag team champion, just a great upside.
Couldn't agree with you anymore. Jason Jordan has taken to this business faster than just about anybody I've ever seen. Only a few short years he's been in the game, and he's already elite. But again, he has a lot of proving to do to many people who believe that he's getting a lot of opportunities here because of his dad, Kurt Angle.
Well, you know what they say about family. If they can't help you out, you don't really need them.
It's because those opportunities, and he's come up short in all of those opportunities tonight. He's got a chance to have a great performance by getting a win over a primetime player like Seth Rollins.
And look at Jordan again, picking Rollins out of the air, and again burying him in the corner. And Jason Jordan continues the pressure on Rollins and the lower back.
Look at this. You've got to appreciate this smash mouth style of Jordan right now. Very effective.
Intense look on the face and in the eyes of Jason Jordan.
I'm hoping that look is. Oh, man.
Shoulder to the gut. Cover by Jordan isn't enough to put Seth away. Wrap the arm and a kick out at two.
I don't know. Gibbs looking a little desperate right now to me.
Well, Jordan looks to me like Jordan's in complete control, but he just about cut Seth Rollins clean in half.
He is in control, but just look at that look in his eye. I've had that look in my eye before, man, not being able to put a guy away.
Yeah, it's called frustration, I believe, as Jordan delivers a right hand right to the face of Seth Rollins. Jason just has to, he's got to dig down here, Corey. He's got to understand he's in there with a multi-time WWE champion, former Money in the Bank winner, tag team champion. Jason Jordan imagines what it could mean for his career to defeat Seth Rollins and then eventually move on and defeat Samoa Joe. That would silence all the doubters.
And there's a lot of doubters, man.
And look at Jordan now. Sold! Backbreaker, knee, lower back, both legs hooked again, and Seth kicks out at two. And to Booker's point earlier, it's one thing for Jason Jordan to continue to have these great performances against the upper echelon of a WWE, but at some point, you've got to start to win.
You know, what's inside that confines, Cole, the only thing you got to fall back on is your skill set. And right now, Jordan's going to have to fall back on it. This kid, Seth Rollins, not going to let him out the back door or anything like that.
Booker, how long did it take you in
your career to figure out how to be one of the most cunning superstars on the roster? But Jordan, and a great throw by Jason. And again, Jordan's in control.
A great counter right there.